Welcome to the series Mastery Composer Elements. Today's video will show you in detail how to create a table to display information in your Shopify store. Table is a versatile tool that can improve your Shopify store's look, functionality, and user-friendliness. It is commonly used to compare similar products or brands. If you offer product variations, a table makes it easy for customers to compare features and prices. Present data-heavy information for specifications, measurements, ingredient lists, or other details with many data points, a table will keep things organized and scannable. Simplify complex options. If you offer subscriptions or service plans with different levels, a table can clearly and concisely summarize the features and benefits of each option. Okay, let's start creating a table in your Shopify store using a Composer right now. First, go to the Shopify dashboard, select App, and open a Composer page builder. In case you haven't installed the app, you can find the link to a Composer on Shopify App Store in this video description. Now choose an existing page that you want to add a table element. You can also create a completely new page by clicking the Start Building button here. In this video, I'll select my home page. Welcome to a Composer editor. Now, locate where you want to place the table element, then drag and drop it. Okay, this is the display of the table element when added to the Composer editor. Now, we will configure this element. Let's start with the Content tab. The Content tab is composed of four simple sections. Layout allows you to change the table format to horizontal or vertical. Row allows you to adjust the number of rows in the table. You just need to drag this bar or enter the number of columns you want in this box. Similar to row, you can also adjust the number of columns as desired by dragging and dropping the adjustment bar or entering numbers. With border collapse, you have three options. Collapse helps you keep the table in default form. Separate and inherit give you the flexibility to change more space between each cell, and you'll set it up using the border spacing option here. Now, we will go to the Design tab. Design tab includes four sections: General, Heading, Table Row, and Table Column. General allows you to edit the table's appearance as desired, like width, alignment, and some of our favorite settings like background, box shadow, border, border radius, and spacing. Heading allows you to adjust the design of the headings in the table. It includes options such as alignment, vertical align, typography, text color, etc. In the table row, you can flexibly set some common options for the table row, such as change the table border style, change the height of table rows, set color, background, font style for odd or even rows. With Table Column, you also have editing options including alignment, vertical align, typography, text color, background color, etc., allowing you to change the color of the text or the background of the table column. When you want to edit table content, it's extremely simple. You just need to click on the content and edit directly in the table. To make this table easier to understand and more beautiful, I will add a heading element and change the background color of the section. I have completed my table. How do you feel? To finish editing, I need to select Save and publish this page. Alright, I have successfully added a table element to my page. Let's check it out. That is the end of today's video. Thank you for watching. If you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment or join the eCompassor community to get quick support and the latest updates. I'm putting the details in the description below. See you next time.